Nice.
One of those pink gowns.
Pink over gowns. Very fetching.
Okay, just through here.
Yep, yeah. Through that. Before we have a look round, what do you do in a normal day?
The staff have got different rotas to do. So some will go and do the rats, some will go and do the monkeys, and some will go and do the rabbits. But they're all checked first thing in the morning, all the cages are looked in to make sure everything's healthy, and then we check their food and their water. And then all the cages have to be scraped out, and then all the cages have to be washed, and they have to be sawdusted and put back into the rooms ready for us to use again.
What changes have you seen since you've been working with animals? Has there been a reduction?
There's been a big reduction since I've been here. We used to, years ago, use many larger animals. We used to have baboons and macaques, and say cats and dogs we don't have anymore. So there's been a change like that over the years. And also within the actual using of rodents, there's been a decline in numbers of animals because the licensees have refined their experiments. There's new technology out now. Sometimes the computers can take over where we used to use our live animals before. We're now using computerised images. So things have changed over the years, definitely. Well, in this room, we have roughly 400 mice, and we've got two rooms like that. So 800 mice in this unit at the moment.
Wow, that's a lot. And what do you use them for?
So these are destined to be used by the dental group. They're looking at salivary glands. So apart from cleaning out the animals, we also need to check to see if they're pregnant. And in this box, we think we have a pregnant animal. So we'll just have a see if she's all right. And you can see that she's got a nice big round tummy. And so therefore she's definitely pregnant. And she's probably about 2 weeks pregnant, so she has another week to go, because mice are 3 weeks before they have their babies, 3 weeks gestation. So having been happy that she's still okay, I put her back nicely in her box and leave them to it. The male stays with the female, he won't attack the babies, they're quite amiable mice.
Okay, so who are these fellas then?
So, well, this is our rat room, and these are a couple of friendly rats which we use for training purposes. So we're using animals quite a bit, so they're a little bit friendly, and I thought they might like to say hello to you today, if you're not too frightened to handle.
Yes, that's
you're
fine.
You're happy for that? Jolly good? Okay. Oh, they're up for it. Come on then. That's it. Oh, you now. You're up. There you go. Who wants to come out?
Oh,
well?
God, go. Both of them.
Whoa. Go for gold.
Not sure if I can handle this.
You'll be all right.
All right, come here.
There you go. Hey. These are Lister hooded rats. Because they've got a black hood, that's why they're called Lister hoodies. Mm-hmm. Just another strain of a typical laboratory animal that we use here.
Mm-hmm. They are very friendly. They seem very calm with being held.
A lot of people give rats a bad press. A lot of people don't like these towels. But they're going to go in your hair.
Or you might want to grab one.
If it just moved to the cage, she'd jump in.
She'll jump.
There you go, well trained.
Amazing.
So what's the difference in terms of how often you feed them?
No difference at all. They're fed exactly the same as the mice are. Two or three times a week we top up the food. The water's topped up two or three times a week. And they have the same sort of bedding material, except their tunnels are obviously a lot bigger than the mouse tunnels. But other than that, they're treated very much the same as the mice. And if we lift this off, it's like just take it off. And you might see a big fat guinea pig.
And what do you use these for?
These have been used for respiratory work. They find out they're studying asthma. And all the years we've had guinea pigs, we've had one escape and it spent all its time sitting in the food hopper. Didn't go anywhere at all. So they're not the brightest of animals, but nevertheless, they do us a favour again because they're good for research. These guys are being used for heart work. They're looking at making them as if they've got heart trouble. So they're on high-fat diet at the moment. Their diet is a normal diet, but it's got high cholesterol in it as well, mixed in it.
So what way do you want to go into this kind of work then?
Well, I didn't really want to do this work to start with. I wanted to work in the zoo or be a vet. But I saw this advertised and I came along to give it a try. And when I first started, I didn't really think I was going to stay here. It was admittedly 40 years ago that I started. And in them days, we used to have quite a lot of dogs. And there was a chap that used to look after the dogs. And he never bothered cleaning them up or anything like this. And they was in their own muck and mess and that. And I said to him, why don't you clean these dogs out? And his answer to me was, why bother? They're going to die anyway. And I thought that was a very terrible thing to say. And I thought, I can't abandon these animals now. They need people here unlike him. They need people here that's going to care for these animals. And I've stayed here ever since, doing that very job, looking after these animals. I feel as if I'm doing my bit for these animals, because if I was really pushed to answer, you know, do I believe in research, animal research? No, I don't. And so I don't believe in it, I don't like it. I understand why it has to be done, I accept why it has to be done, and I'm hoping in the years and years to come, there'll be no research and animals won't have to be used. That'd be great. But all the time they are being used, let's have people in charge of them who care. Because at the end of the day, all these animals are doing us a big favour. If they've got a white bit showing there, that's their tummy. They've got milk in their tummy. So therefore we know mum's feeding them. Milk in that tummy. Yep. So all the babies are being fed nicely.